Christmas is coming again. He's got a sleigh full, it's not gonna stay full. He's got stuff to drop at every stop of the way. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Guys, Christmas is coming again.
Here, with the answer to the prayers that you made through the year, you'll get yours. If you've done everything you should, extra special. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas.
Oh. Okay, my favorite part of the concert. I get to say a lot. Well, thank you very much for coming. I can't actually see you, so I'm hoping there are people out there. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Dr. Clifton. I'm the director of music here at Mount St. Mary. These are some of the most talented, hardworking people I've ever really, I think, worked with in the entirety of my career from college on the way down. We talked when we were praying in the basement about being given keys to a Ferrari, and that's really what this has been. And it's been a really fun journey to think about where we came from just 4 years ago. And so to kind of give you a visual snapshot of what that was, if the original fearsome choir people would come off, and then our two remaining seniors from the original group. With the exception of some very talented young ladies who are at the University of Dallas and UCO, and I think that's it. I think they all went to about the same colleges. This is what we started with 4 years ago, and we've built it into everything that you've seen. I always get nostalgic this time of year because that's required because it's Christmas and you're supposed to think back. And then, this is always the end of a cycle for us where, we began this journey in December of last year and kind of finish it here. And to kind of think about what we did, we were joking around about the pieces that we did the very first year, and we were trying to find ways to put everything together. And it was a pretty fun thing. And to be able to do all this now has just been absolutely outstanding. I would be remiss if I didn't thank you as well and your support of the department, of the school, of them. It's a lot of hours, and you know that better than I do. You've heard it at home, hopefully, because they're practicing. And, you've kind of witnessed that journey and instrumental, just to kind of talk about them. Never before have we gone through a full-fledged marching band season until this year, which delayed concert band and it delayed jazz band. And so they actually began working on the music you just heard at the end of October. And this, just to kind of give you an idea of grade level, this music, there's five essentially grade levels. They leapt two. So not only did they learn harder music, more music, faster, but they also played it at a much, much higher level. And each instrument has a different role based on its ensemble. So when we're in marching band, for instance, they're all love it because they get to play as loud as they want to most of the time-ish. And then when we get into concert band, it's completely different. We get into jazz band, it's completely different. So they constantly have to relearn roles and things like that. You guys can sit. I know it's weird. And then, the vocal ensemble, just literally and truly, they don't have much more up to go as far as musical difficulty. Most of the literature that we perform for you tonight is at the college level. It's highly dissonant. Dissonance is much more difficult to sing than consonants. Yes, it's in English, but the way that they make their mouths is now borderline, perfect. And the same thing with jazz band. I'm sure you heard the music was sounding very, very dissonant. Well, they, believe it or not, were playing all the right notes. And those cluster chords and everything like that, it's very, very difficult to not only tune those, but to hit every single note properly and every single rhythm. And again, their strength still in the vocal ensemble is a cappella. We heard the accompaniment last night for the first time. They had never heard that's every competition, that's every concert. They hear it for the first time. This is something that we've been doing for a long time. It's much more difficult to learn the music a cappella than it is to learn the music with the accompaniment. So we make it perfect. We hear everything in the a cappella format. Then we introduce the accompaniment, and they go, okay. And, just kind of do their thing. And so truly extraordinary. I also want to talk about, our freshmen. Our freshmen may or may not have known what they were getting into when they joined this ensemble or this department. I kind of want to pick on Julianne over here. Julianne in marching band was the very first person to memorize her music as a freshman. She memorized her music before everyone else did and was significantly more difficult than anything that she had done. And then our freshman vocalists, when we did our range tests, it was pretty hard to hear them. They were kind of nervous. I look like this, and all this kind of stuff. And they've gone from that to really taking ownership of everything they've done. I'm supremely proud of Abigail. Abigail is one of our cornerstone students at Mount St. Mary. She is such a gift. She's such a blessing. She has such a tremendous voice, a tremendous spirit. She's really uplifted the class. She's an absolute joy and privilege to work with, as is everybody else. And, you know, for our seniors here that are standing, this is the end. I don't really know what to do without them. I'm going to fail them all, parents, so we're going to we'll take that tuition and money and donate it somewhere. But, I truly, when I think about next year, it's going to be really weird. They are my first class. 4 years ago, we started this thing together. None of them have left. All the original people that were here when the department started, when I got here, are still here. And they've persevered with me. We've had, battles. We've had tears, sort of. Kind of built it to where we are, and if you look in your programs, I mean, that's our competition success. But it transcends that. I hope that everything that they've learned are life skills and things that they can take beyond music, perseverance, learning to love the process. And there's so many parallels between music and sports that can benefit them each way. So when I say there's some of the hardest working people, I know that's a cliche, but I truly, truly mean that. To hear what you've heard tonight was extremely difficult for them to undertake. And same thing again with vocal. They learn more music. The pieces are longer, they're much more difficult and things like that than they've ever done before. So again, thank you for giving me the privilege to work with them. They inspire me, they enlighten me. I learn from them as much as I hope that they learn from me. And I wouldn't be here if it weren't for them. And I mean that literally and figuratively, because I wouldn't have a job. But we appreciate you all. So we're going to close the concert. They wouldn't let me get rid of O Holy Night, so we're going to do that again. But it gets better every time. We're going to have a nice little fun piece for you, a Rudolph piece, and then close the concert like we always do with Silent Night. There's a reception downstairs after. Love to see all of you. Please come up, shake hands, take pictures, kiss babies, whatever. And we will hopefully see you guys in the spring. So thank you very much.